Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. In this video we are going to see how we can turn on and off this AC bulb using a sound control with this sound module. So you will clap or shout and the light will be on and then again it will be off. As you can see here, the light is off. Now this light is off and I'm clapping. The light is on and another clap, the light will be off. Same thing, I can shout. Light off, light off. You can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/arduino. This project will have two codes. One would be for the basic one that you turn on and off the light with a digital, and also I will provide another code which is advanced one with the analog. So with the analog you can turn on and off with a certain specific audio level, so not necessarily it could be a shout, it could be a different sound level that you can set and test and turn on and off a light. So let's get started. So word of caution that this is involved AC power. Once you are connected to AC light, for example, once you connected to the AC, you are not supposed to touch this. Once the relay is connected to the power outlet, you are not supposed to touch this, and be careful. And also, because the bottom of the relay is metallic and it has contacts, make sure that you put the relay on an insulated wood, plastic, paper, or something like that. So this is the module, the sound module. We have here 4 pins. Here is the data out or digital out. The second pin is the positive, which will be connected to 5 volts. And then we have the ground. This will be connected to the ground. And the last one is analog out. So we are connecting it to A0. So that could be read as A0. And then this is an op amp, dual op amp, low voltage op amp. That this module is used for majority of the sensors. So the main sensing element is a condenser microphone here. So, and then we have a potentiometer, a multi-turn potentiometer that you can change the sensitivity of this. So the width of this is 15.1 millimeter. The length of this is 36.8 millimeter. The depth of the device is 13.1 millimeter. So let me explain the relay now. The relay is 5 volts, so it doesn't need other external power, so it can be powered with the Arduino. So we have 3 connections here. So this is common, so you always connect your one of the wires that you connect to AC or DC, whatever, heater, light, whatever. So you connected, the light is connected here, one of them, and the other one will be either connected here or here depending on the application. So this means normally connected, so without any power to this, it's always connected. If you connect another wire here, so it will be connected and your device will have power. And this is normally open, so when you connect the middle here and the other one is here, it will be normally open. When the relay energizes or get signal, this will connect these two wires. We have two LEDs here. This red LED is for when it gets power, and then this will activate it when it gets signal. So the 3 inputs or the 3 pin for the relay are VCC. So this is VCC and this is ground, so you will connect this to 5 volt and this is connected to the ground or negative wire. And this is input. The input is where the signal comes. This is connected to the pin 10 in this application. When the signal comes, this light will be on. So let me explain the AC bulb here. So this is a table light that is connected to the wall outlet, and then the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these two wires here, so let me show you. So I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. Now I have connected the AC wires between the common and normally open NO. So let me explain the wiring here for the relay. This wire goes to VCC, this to 5 volts of Arduino, this goes to the ground, this goes to pin 10 of Arduino. Here, this goes here to pin 10. This module on the left side, this goes for, this was for digital, this has not been used, I did not use it for analog. And then we have this plus, this wire goes to 5 volts when it says plus, and then we have ground, this goes to ground. So now the light is off, and here on the screen, as you can see, it says light off. So let me clap. Now the light is on, and also the text shows that the light is on. So you can use this for some kind of control, or maybe by saying light, 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 and so forth. So you'll play with this and change the sensitivity until it works for your application. So let me explain now the code. We are setting the number 2 for the variable sound, which will be used for the pin 2 of digital. And then we are setting relay pin, another variable equal to 10. So that refers to pin 10. So everywhere we need 2 and 10, we will use these two values. And these values are not to be changed, because these are used to, when the light is on, it keeps it on. When the light is off, it keeps it off. So do not touch or play with them if you want the program to work. Then inside the setup, from here to here, we set the serial monitor begin with 9600 baud, which refers to this, and 9600 is the number that's at the corner here. And then we set the sound, which is pin 2, as an input with a pull-up resistor, and also we set the relay pin, which is 10, as an output. So this will control the relay. Then we are coming to the loop, which starts from there and ends here. Inside the loop, we just say digital read pin 2, which is a sound. So read the value and store it in the variable called val. Val is an integer variable that has been defined here. So now this will hold the value as either 1 or 0 or high or low. And here we are comparing it and saying if val this is equal high, and these two ampersand sign means and light on is equal low. So light on is a value that is set here. So 0 means low, 1 means high. So these are can be exchanged equivalently. And then we have this one to store the status, 1 minus hertz. Hertz is a variable that is here. And then we are waiting 100 milliseconds. This is a very critical value. So initially do not change it, but later on you have to change it according to your environment or the occurrence of sound. For example, if you make this too short, or 20 seconds or 30 seconds, and you clap, it might not be able to read the clap. The clap will be long, and this will not be able to read it, because 30 milliseconds is too fast. Or if you shout with your voice, or the response of the board might be slow. So anyway, this is used, and then we say value equal light. So from here to here is to keep the light on when it's on, and keep it off when it's off. And then this is the main section of the code that controls the relay. So if hertz is equal high, this equal means equal. So if hertz is equal high, then do this. What does this mean is light on, it will print the light on here, the text for us, and also we say 10, relay pin, which is 10, equal low. Low is used because this relay that I'm using is low level trigger. So with the low, it will be triggered. So we set it low. So if you want to control a motor, heater, door lock, whatever you want with the sound, so put your code here, the highlighted area. Else means if there is no sound, then do this. So the same way you can control your device by removing this code and putting yours. Or maybe just put something extra here underneath or above this. So somewhere in between this closing and opening, or between this opening and closing. And then again, we have 100 milliseconds. This starts with 100 milliseconds, and then If you wanted to manipulate it, if it doesn't work, maybe change it. Otherwise, it should be fine. So the loop continues like that. So the first part of this application is done, so you can get the code and it will work fine. But if you want to going to use the analog and do more control over the value, then continue watching, and it will take a while, but you will learn a lot of other stuff that you might use in your projects. Okay, now we are using the advanced mode. In this mode, we are not using the digital, we are using the analog out, which is the last pin here. So to set this first, the first thing is that you have to rotate this until you see this clicking. You see, after that, rotate it clockwise, the way the clock rotates, until it stops. So now the light is off, the light is on. Light on, light. So the value is set. This is the value from the sensor. As you can see, it says light off at the moment, and this is 5:30. So we are at 5:28, 5:20. That's why light is off. So I have to increase my voice to make it 5:30. Hello? Hello? Or maybe I should clap. So as soon as it claps, the value increases and then the light is on. And here, the light was on and the value was about 520, 518, 520. When I made a clap, the audio, the voice become, the value become 645 and the light was off. Until again, this is 527, 526, and then when there was another voice or clap, so 530 triggered it. So you can select the value here. So do not touch it with this 530, it will be fine, but your environment or the room that has different voice level or noise level, that just change it a little up or down and you will find the right value to trigger this. So now I'm going to show you the advanced code for this light sensor. So we are setting the pin 10 for the relay pin and then 530 for the sound value. This is the value that we are setting to trigger the light. So as you can see here, I've frozen the screen. 526, the light was on, all these values. When it becomes 530, some clamp or high audio level triggered it to go off. And again, it's off and off until, again, from 530, it becomes 531 and the light is on. And again, it's from 26, it jumps to 546 and the light goes off. So this is the value. And then you do not play or touch these values. These are necessary for program to function. For example, keeping the light on, turning the light on and keeping it on, and turning the light off and keeping it off. So inside the setup, we set 9600 baud for the serial monitor to work, and then relay for the output. And this is as if I type 10 as an output. And then inside the loop from here to the end in here, we first say analog read, which leads analog zero value, and then stores it into val. And then here we are comparing and doing the comparison. This val, which is read from the analog zero, if it's bigger than sound value. Sound value is a value that you set here, which is 530, the sound value. And light on is equal low. So this 2% sign mean and. So this must be true and this must be true. So this can happen. So these are done from here to here. This is to keep the light on or keep it off. The job of that. And here is a important part. We say if heard, which audio is heard, is equal high, then print the value of the audio, which is this one, and also print the text, which is this text, and then set the relay low, because this relay is low trigger, so the relay will go on. So if you want to do something else when the audio is heard, you can do it here. Control a motor, servo, close the door, whatever you want, you can do with this highlighted area and put whatever else you wish to do. If this is false, then we say else, do this. This is the same as above, with the exception that we say pin, relay pin high, so this will turn off the relay, and then we wait for 100 milliseconds and the loop continues. This is very important. If you put it too short, the same audio or a sound or clap will turn on the light on and turn it off at the same time, because it will read for the next one too quick. If you put it too large, which will be too slow, then your audio might not be heard, because at that time the system might have been waiting at that point. Because if you put it 500 milliseconds, half a second, a clamp cannot be heard. So make sure that you find the right value here. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video if you like it, and also subscribe to get update of my upcoming videos, and also share it. If you have any question or comment, please type it at the comment box. I will try my best to answer and reply.